This video is about BJT Wilson current mirror. We see the transfers current ratio and the output resistance of this configuration. In 1967, George Wilson was challenged to find an improved current mirror overnight that would use only 3 transistors. Wilson won the challenge with this elegant configuration. Let's see how it works. First, we can see the current in the 2 branches. IRF biases Q1, forcing the VBE1 voltage, which is applied on Q2 base emitter 2, in this way creating a current IC2 in the second branch of the mirror. This IC2 is more or less equal to IRF, and it is the mirrored current. The working principle is equal to that of the basic mirror, but here we see that the third transistor balances better the currents in the 2 branches. We can see this in a visual way. We can start from the basic configuration, considering all the transistors matched, and see that from IRF, which flows in the first branch, the parts 2IB current, but we give back 1IB to the first branch. So, from the first branch, we miss 1IB, which we give to the second branch. This is one cause of a mismatch between IRF and the mirrored current. The Wilson configuration is more balanced. You see that from the first branch departs 1IB, and later we give it back. So the base current balance is 0 in the first and the second branch. Some currents depart, but the same currents come back. Now let's see the current transfer ratio. First, we note that IRF is IB3 plus IC1. Secondly, in the Q3 emitter node, we can write this equation where 2IB is the current going to the base of Q1 and Q2. We can write IB as IC2 divided by beta, and the equation becomes this, and grouping IC2, it became this. So IC2 is equal this, and we can write IE3 as sum of IC3 plus IB3, and IB3 as IC3 divided by beta 3, or simply by beta if the transistors are matched. This is the relation between IC2 and IC3, where IC3 is the output current IOUT. So, remembering that IRF is IB3 plus IC1, but IC1 is equal to IC2 equal to IC, we can write this. Remembering that IB3 is IC3 divided by beta, and IC is equal to IC2, we can get this. And sorting, we get this. So, the current transfer ratio, which is IOUT divided by IRF, is more or less this. This transfer ratio is much better than that of the basic current mirror, because the error is divided by the square of beta. In order to calculate the output resistance, which tells us how stable is the output current regardless of the applied load, we put a test voltage on the output and we measure the current created. The ratio V-test divided I-test gives the output resistance. We use the small signal hybrid P model for the transistor Q3, and Q1 and Q2 are in a basic mirror configuration, so we put them in a box in which IC1 is equal to IE3. So we have that the current I test enters in this node and goes out from this other node, and the I test is equal to the sum of IE3 and IC1, so it is equal to 2 times IC1, or we can say that IC1 is I test half. Looking from the emitter of Q3 towards the mirror, we see a low resistance, in any case very low in comparison with little RO, so we can assume V-test dropping completely on little RO, so we can write the Kirchhoff current law to this node, so I-test is equal to V-test divided by little RO plus IB, but IB is equal to minus IC1, so minus beta IC1. Remembering that IC1 is I test half, we can write this equation. Sorting things out, we get this equation. And finally, we can say that the output resistance Vtest divided Itest is more or less equal to beta half times little r, which is much more than the output resistance of the basic configuration, which is simply little r. So the Wilson configuration improves both the current transfer ratio and the output resistance in comparison with the basic current mirror configuration. But we still have an asymmetry because the base collector voltage of Q1 is equal to the base emitter voltage of Q3, more or less 0.7 volts. But the base collector voltage of Q2 remains to zero, so IC2 and IC1 are slightly different. For this reason, we have the improved Wilson configuration, in which adding a transistor, we force the base collector voltage of Q1 to zero. Please leave me a comment, let me know if you liked this video. Make sure you put the thumb up, click the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel.